Hello students of class 10, welcome to chemistry class. We have been learning chemical bonding from chapter 2, and I had given you an introduction about chemical bonding. Then we learned about why do atoms combine. Then afterwards we talked about electron dot structure. Then we learned about the octet rule, and now today I would like to discuss with you atoms and ions, and also about oxidation and reduction. So let us learn in detail. So this is class 10 chemistry, chapter 2, chemical bonding. We heard some introduction, then we learned about why do atoms combine. And we also learn about electron dot structures, then octet rule. Today we shall learn about atoms and ions. What are atoms and what are ions, and how do they differ from each other in properties? Now, first and foremost, atoms tend to complete their octets either by losing or by gaining electrons, right? Now I will deal with it very elaborately when I explain with the example. Now first understand the meaning of this statement. They tend to complete their octets. I told you octet means 8 electrons in the outermost shell. That is it. Either by losing or by gaining electrons. Now the result of this is the formation of ion. See, when atom lose or gain, what the result comes, that is what is known as ion. Alright? So, let me just explain to you with an example. So, when we come to the board, let us say, now this is sodium atom. This is sodium atom. Now, the atomic number of sodium atom is 11, right? Now, here we know that atom is electrically neutral. We should understand that atom is electrically neutral. That means it has 11 proton and 11 electron. That's it. So, equal number of protons and equal number of electron in the atom. So, this is called a neutral atom. And what about the electronic configuration? 2, 8, 1. The first shell, 2 electrons. Second shell, 8 electrons. And the outermost shell, 1 electron. This is called valence electron. Now, this is the electron which is going to react with another atom. Now, the whole aim of this atom is to combine with another atom. How? Either by losing or by gaining. Now, in this case, to complete its octet or noble gas configuration, either it has to lose the last electron or it has to gain some electron in the last shell. Now here, gaining means 7 electrons it has to gain. Is it possible to gain 7 electrons? It is not at all possible. But losing this one is easier. So by losing this one, it is going to attain Na plus. Now what does it mean? Now this means here, this gains 2, 8. See, the electronic configuration of this one is 2, 8. So, this has attained the noble gas configuration, 2, 8. So, this is what is called ion. This is what is called ion, Na plus. Whereas, this is called atom. Okay? This is called atom, neutral atom. So, what happens? Now, focus the whole thing. So, the last electron is lost and it has gained electronic configuration. Eh? Stable gas electronic configuration. Noble gas electronic configuration. So, Na becomes Na plus. So, how shall we deal with this? Na, by losing one electron, it becomes Na plus. Yes? Now, this is the equation. Right? So, this is what is known as cation. This is what is known as cation. Alright? This is what is known as cation. Now, let us take, for example, chlorine. Okay, it's chlorine. So ion means there are two ions, cations and anion. So one I explained to you. Another one is anion. So let's say chlorine. Now the electronic configuration of, in the atomic number of chlorine is 17. What is the electronic configuration? 2, 8 and 7. First shell 2, second shell 8 and in the last shell that is 7 electron. Right. Now here you see, this is neutral atom. Why neutral atom? Because 17 proton and 17 electron. So equal number of protons, equal number of electron. Therefore it is a neutral atom. And you cannot lose these 7 electrons. It's very, very difficult to lose all the 7 electrons. But it can gain 1 electron, which is easier. So it will gain 1 electron. Thus, it will become Cl minus. Cl minus. Okay? So it will become Cl minus. So we can write it here 2, 8, 8. Now you see here. Now this has attained a noble gas configuration. Noble gas configuration. 2, 8, 8. So this is an ion. This is an atom. See, this is an atom. This is an ion. Now, what ion is this? This is an anion. Why anion? Because it gains electron. It gains electron. Therefore, it is an anion. Okay. So that's it. All right. So now let us come. Let's see how they are different. How they differ from each other in their properties. How do the properties of an ion differ from those of the parent atom? Okay, pay attention. Ion is formed due to loss or gain of electrons from an atom. I already explained to you. Secondly, ion has a stable noble gas electronic configuration. Yes, this is, that is 2, 8, 8 or 2, 8. Right, noble gas configuration. Properties of ions are dictated by the electrical charge on them. Yes, so if it is a positive charge, it is known as a cation. If it is a negative charge, it is known as an anion. Let's say here, chlorine gas. Now, this is a molecule. Okay, this is a molecule. Here, chlorine 2 is a, Cl2 is there for the molecule. It is poisonous. Okay, whereas chloride ion is not poisonous. So, that's how we can see the. Now, you see how we can differentiate. You know, atom electrically neutral. Whereas ion is electrically charged, either cation or anion. It contains equal number of protons and electrons, whereas it contains unequal number of protons and electrons. I already explained to you. Now, here look at the size here. Size of cation is smaller than atom. Cation is smaller than atom. Why? Because in the atom, the number of proton is more. Number of electron is less. Okay? Whereas in anion is bigger. Why? Number of anion, number of electron is more and proton is less. Noble gases exist as independent atoms. All other atoms exist as a molecule. Here, ions can exist independently in solution, mainly in the electrolytic solution, mixing and so on. They can exist independently. Right? So that's all about the atom and ion. Next topic, let's learn about oxidation and reduction. First, let us just understand what are these things, then I explain to you. Oxidation, reductions. In the previous classes, like class 9 and 8 and so on, we learned them separately to understand what they are. But, see, the reaction can be separate reaction, like oxidation reaction and reduction reaction, can be also oxidation reduction reaction together. Now, when this oxidation reduction reaction takes place together simultaneously, then it is known as a redox reaction, right? Now, let us understand what is oxidation. Oxidation reaction means reaction in which loss of electrons takes place, and reduction means gain of electron takes place, right? And oxidation reduction, both are reciprocal. They are mutually dependent upon each other. Understand? So, that is the meaning of oxidation and reduction. Oxidizing agent. What are oxidizing agent? The substance which is capable of accepting electrons from other substance. For example, chlorine. They are all oxidizing agent. In short, I can tell you all the non-metals can be an oxidizing agent. And similarly, reducing agent. The substance which is capable of losing electrons to other substance. Example, sodium. So, here for example, metals. All metals can be reducing agents. Understand? Now, I will explain to you with an example. Come. Let us see. Let us look at the board here. Now, let us talk about copper. So, your first oxidation. Okay? Oxidation means, what did I tell you? It's a loss of electron. Loss of electron. Oxidation means loss of electron. Loss of electrons here. Say here, copper. Copper. Right? Copper loses two electrons. Copper electron loses two electrons and becomes copper 2 plus. See? Copper 2 plus. And it's very, very beautiful. So here, what happened here? How many electrons? Losing of two electrons has taken place. Losing of two electrons have taken place. Therefore, this is a oxidation reaction. This is oxidation reaction. What is the reduction reaction? Reduction reaction. See, the opposite. What is the reduction reaction? Our reduction reaction is, now suppose you have got here copper 2 plus. Copper 2 plus. I have taken the ion. Right? Now, when it gains two electrons, when it gains plus 2, when it gains two electrons, it becomes a copper neutral atom. It becomes copper neutral. The other way around. The copper neutral atom. So, this is what is called a reduction reaction. So, here what happened? Gaining of electron takes place. Gaining of electron takes place. Right? So, that is about a oxidation and a reduction reaction. Right? Now, let's talk about here redox reaction. So, copper oxide. Copper oxide plus hydrogen. Let's take it here. Now this is copper plus H2O. Now here, both the reactions take place simultaneously. This is known as the redox reaction. Oxidation reduction together. Redox reaction. This is known as redox. Oxidation reduction together taking place simultaneously. How? How? I'll show you here. Understand here. Now, hydrogen takes out this oxygen. Hydrogen takes out this oxygen. Therefore, copper oxide becomes copper. Right? Removal of oxygen. This is reduction reaction. This is reduction reaction. This is reduction reaction. Whereas hydrogen becomes water. This is oxidation. This is oxidation. Oxygen is added. Oxygen is added to hydrogen. Right? Here, what happened here? Here, what happened? Oxidation, what is doing? This is removing this oxygen. Removing this oxygen. Right? So, that's how we can kind of conclude that in this reaction, oxidation-reduction reaction taking place together, it is known as a redox reaction. Alright. And in this case, what we can say, hydrogen can be reducing agent. Hydrogen can be reducing agent here. Understand? Because it is removing oxygen. Hydrogen can be reducing agent, whereas copper oxide can be oxidizing agent. Right? So, like that, we can understand. Therefore, my dear students, with this, we have come to the end of this class today. And tomorrow, we shall continue with another topic. Till then, keep reading and post your comments. Thank you.